before everyone starts, just want to remind the timer, the time criteria for all the speeches for this, this session is 4 to 6 minutes. So 6 minutes red light.
4 minutes
green
light. If you want to be trusted, you need to be honest. If you want to be honest, you need to be true. And if you want to be true, you need to be yourself. Master of Ceremonies, fellow Toastmasters, and distinguished guests. A very good evening to all of you.
Good evening.
Good evening. I'm Vivian, and I'm from India, a place called Chennai. A place known for its South Indian food. I spent most of my childhood in Chennai. As I started growing up, I started developing hatred towards the place. Maybe it was the unbearable summer. I couldn't take it. Those days when my brother and I would come back from school with those heavy books in our bags, and we had to climb 3 floors to just enter the house. Those days, when I used to feel sick and horrible, we gradually moved to Bahrain. And moving to Bahrain was a bit of a new thing for me. It didn't feel like home, but I still felt happy. I started making friends, I started going out, I started socializing with people. I started socializing so much that I fell into traps with my friends. Friends who were fake. Friends who took my friendship for granted. Maybe I just wanted to fit in, but deep down I knew this person was in me. I was becoming unhappy day by day. One day, it finally struck me. I asked myself, why am I doing this? Why should I change myself for the happiness of others? I might as well be myself, and the right people will enter my life. I remembered the person I was back in Chennai. I was a person who never tried to fit in, because the people accepted me for who I was. I then realized what value my place had. I then realized that I hated it for no reason. I started getting into track again, and I found myself much more happier around people. Why do we feel happy when we're ourselves around people? Have you ever wondered? It simply is because we are seeing ourselves into being someone we're not. I'm going to tell you all 2 incidents which took place in my life, which showed me the importance of being myself. One such incident took place when I was around 14 years old, and I had the immense interest in music. My parents always thought it was a big distraction for me, and they never really encouraged me. But I used to have a teacher back in school who used to encourage me a lot. I used to sit for hours together in the music room, sing and play instruments, non-stop. My teacher understood that my love for music was not normal. When my parents saw that they sent And when my parents saw that, they themselves were really surprised that I'd be hiding this from them the whole time. Again, it just took me a little bit of guts to get up there and tell myself that I want to be myself, that I want to do what I want to do, what I like to do. Another incident which took place was when I was just in high school, and it was a part of my life where I had to choose stream I was going to take. My parents advised me to always take something which was easy, like commerce. But back then, I wasn't really a big fan of commerce. I wanted to go into science and pursue science. So I told my parents that I want to take science. I know that it may be hard, but this is what I want. 2 years I struggled. I have to say, it was not easy at all. I had to give it my all to pass for good grades. At the end of high school, I made one decision. I told my parents, I cannot do this. I simply wanted to quit. They questioned me. They asked me, why did you pursue this if you're not going to take it anymore further? They were really angry. But then I told them, this is not me. This is not my cup of tea. At the end of the day, I have to be happy. I have to be myself. Right now, I'm in college, I've pursued commerce, and I have no regrets. I have nothing to regret because I did what felt right. I did what made me happy. And even though today I have pursued commerce, I feel it's not a wrong decision because I'm very sure I don't regret it. Because I know that if I had taken commerce in high school, not taken science, I would have regretted it. The very most important thing that we have to realize is that we shouldn't be fake around anyone. We should just be ourselves. Fake a smile, fake a laugh, or fake an attitude. But just keep in mind that you're merging the person inside you, that you're not giving everyone the person who you actually are. Being fake, is that going to last forever? It's not going to last. But what about being yourself? Will that last forever? Of course it will last. Will that make you happy? Of course it will make you happy.